Two words of Christ, your girl Karina here, and happy blessed Thursday! And today is also the feast day of our blessed Mother Lady of Fatima, Our Lady of Fatima, and also, and also the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we got two in one today, and I'm just so excited because it's very rare to have the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ and also Our Lady Fatima both on the same day. So it's such a blessing for us to embrace this day today. And plus, it's super sunny out, so it's just like, what? Anyways, thank you so much for tuning into the video on this wonderful podcast and channel for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I hope and pray that you will please subscribe to my YouTube channel right here and ring the notification bell to get notified of any new videos that I'll be uploading every Tuesday and every Thursday for you wonderful true words of Christ. And thank you so much for those that have been subscribed. And for those that are newly subscribed, it's such an honor to be able to have you journey with me in this wonderful time of persevering and patience and burning, because honestly we're all in time of waiting. So this is the time. So just take this time to really focus yourself on being a true warrior for Christ every single day and utilizing everything that you have and utilizing all the resources that God blessed you with to its maximum point, so that God will provide as you go along that journey. So if you don't have anything right now, like if your resources are like this and your goal is like this and like so on and so forth, God will provide for you. So always remind yourself that all the time. So start humbly. Begin humbly. Have your humble beginnings. Start a ministry as long as the Holy Spirit is with you always. And as always, just always pursue the fire of Christ that you have in your heart. Not being afraid. Just as our Lady of Fatima always says to us all the time, do not be afraid. Like, that's really her message leading all of us closer to her son Jesus. So just remember that all the time, that when you pursue something for Christ or any ministry or whatnot, just always remember that God will provide for you. So do not despair. Don't think that you don't have anything and so you can't do it. No, just try what you can. Try using everything, especially the best thing you have, which is your talent, your skill, and your gifts that God blessed you uniquely with. So always remember that. Begin there. Start somewhere. Use everything you have and be grateful. And just see how God will really open more doors for you and open more ways for you to make things possible, all for His glory. So always remember that you can do it. You are capable with God. You become able. You become capable. Always remember that. I always have to say that because it's so true. Because really, without God, you cannot accomplish great things. Without God, you cannot be successful. Without God, you cannot do anything to glorify His name. Without Him, you can't do it. You can't do it alone. So therefore, always allow yourself to reach out to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, especially on this day, Ascension of our Lord. Hello, it's been 40 days after Easter. So this is when you know time is flying. So that's why you utilize every single day as a way to glorify God's name in every way possible, so that you know that you are progressing and you're becoming a fire of a disciple of Christ. You know, you gotta try. That's where it all begins. You gotta try somewhere. And then just see how God will lead you from here to here to here. Like, and it's such a beautiful map to see, like, how your life will really unveil itself and really just spread out and branch itself naturally, because God is with you, right? God is with you always and always, always. When you have Him in the center of any ministry you do and at the center of anything you do to glorify His name and kingdom. So always remember that, my true words for Christ. And so Christ led me to the song today, Thy Will. I know I did a cover on this before, but I love how our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ led me to sing it again, because it's all for Him. And we have to really follow that example that our Blessed Mother Mary did. Like, she said, you know, that will be done, like, according to your word. Something along those lines. I think I messed that up, but she definitely surrendered herself to God and accepting that yes, being our Lord, being the mother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, right? So just allow yourself to follow her example and to see how beautiful fruits you will really bestow, you will really bear, all according to His time. So with that said, I hope and pray that you always follow the will of God, even if it's in the midst of waiting, like no tomorrow. But God is right there. He can see you struggle. He can see you go through hardships. He can see you literally have those times of impatience, right? But just know that he's there, and just know that he has a perfect time for everything, especially for what you're fervently praying for. No doubt in that. So with that said, and as I would say in all my videos, don't be afraid to be true words of Christ.
Knees all that comes to me, that he will be done.